Lecturers, Bernard Timmins, presented the idea to the class, and it didn't have, there was no marks going for it or no credits or anything. It was completely voluntary.
So we were put in a group with Nadine, who is blind, and it was really helpful to find out sort of, or to learn, I guess, about what it's like living without sight and what sort of problems they have on a day-to-day basis. It was great being able to have somebody there with you that you could sort of run through your sort of ideas and concepts and little thoughts.
The design challenge gave me the chance to pass on a bit of experience that I have with assistive technology, and also to kind of develop some ideas that I've had regarding assistive technology that might be useful for both myself and for other vision impaired people.
That was the first time that we've actually really like gone out in the field and actually met up with people and started working. Before that, it was always just hypothetical situations. Going out and meeting Nadine was great, meeting all the people from Enable Ireland. It was really good. It was a lot better than just sitting in class and just reading off this made up, you know, situation off a sheet, actually going out and seeing what she wanted and what she thought about things. And once we came back with an idea and she liked it and she thought it was useful, that was just really, really good. It's great.
I really enjoyed coming up with the brainstorming session with the clients, like coming up with just absolutely outrageous design ideas to suit them, and then sort of like toning them down to actually make them, you know, feasible and realistic.
I had so many ideas that I wanted to try and save the world. I needed to narrow down my ideas, and they were very enthusiastic as well, so we had to kind of narrow down one project and try and work with that.
The atmosphere was fantastic. Big group of people who had a very natural, comfortable, creative atmosphere. You know, it was very supportive, and I think everybody who went there had a bit of a laugh as well. As you know, it was, they're great people you end up working with, and really everybody there was coming to it with or without a disability, but with a sense of being there to enjoy themselves as well, not just to work all the time and kind of strive for a product, but to enjoy the process that was in it as well.
The technology is already there. We based it off existing technology because we didn't want to just make up something and go, oh yeah, this exists or that exists, this will work. We actually went out and found all this technology that exists in different places, so going out and meeting those different people and then combining it together, hopefully, in the app.
Well, I'd like to approach major supermarkets, you know, to get behind the idea and to support it.
We put a lot of thought into how it would work, how it should work. By this point, I guess the sort of actually writing the code and the software for the technology is what needs to be done, and looking into real sort of protection of ideas, or maybe even the open source sort of network that would need to exist behind it, and how you can get it to as many people as possible as quickly as possible.
For product designers trying to come up with something that's universally accessible, obviously it's going to be difficult because they're not going to have expertise in every area, but there are people that have expertise in every area, and they are the users themselves.